Dave Cohen catching up with Georgia State's head football coach, Shawn Elliott. Coach, great to see you. I knew you were missing me now that football season's over.
I did, but I did catch you on the ESPN highlights the other night with the basketball win over Alabama, so that was good to hear your voice.
Well, appreciate it. That was a great win for Coach Hunter and the Panthers. Let's talk a little Georgia State football. Busy time of the year. Season's over, but you guys have been hitting the ground hard on the recruiting trail as you continue to build this football program and push it forward.
Yeah, we have. We've been traveling the Southeast here in the state of Georgia and really trying to get in the homes of these guys that we're trying to bring in here to Georgia State University. This will be our third class here and almost completely have flipped our roster after this signing class. So our coaches are out on the road. I've been out on the road, and it's been nonstop ever since the season's been done.
Georgia State was one of the youngest football teams in FBS this year. 25 true or redshirt freshmen actually saw the field this year.
Yeah, they did. That's good and bad, of course, as you can tell. But we're looking forward to it. The development of those guys here in the offseason is really, really critical. The young bodies, the young minds that we can really mold, the experience they gained from a year ago, and they're all coming back. So that's a really good thing.
Yeah, 61 starts among your true and redshirt freshmen, and there's no other way to get players, young players, playing time than to put them on the field.
Yeah, that's amazing when you say it's 61 starts for true freshmen or redshirt freshmen. And that tells you, you know, just how young we were out there at times on the football field. But, just to continue building those guys. And like I said, we've got to have development with those young guys. Our roster really has to grow and gain an edge this offseason, both physically and mentally. And I'm looking forward to it. It's an exciting time to be around such a young group. And they're all so influential. You can really go in there and make your mark this offseason with these guys.
Let's talk a little bit about Georgia State's quarterback position. Last 4 years, Panther fans had seen guys like Nick Arbuckle for a couple of years, Connor Manning for a couple of years. Talk about Dan Ellington and the impact he made in his first season with Georgia State.
Yeah, I really enjoyed Dan this year from the time, it was about this time a year ago that we actually started recruiting Dan and getting involved with him, and it was a short recruiting process, but he turned out to be everything we expected. I mean, had a really good football season for us, really commands our offense well, can run with his legs, and has a good passing arm as well. But I think Dan's senior season is going to be very special. I look forward to seeing how he develops mentally over the off season, into spring practice, and then coming into next season. Dan's very, very dangerous.
You know, as coaches and I have talked about the advancement of the running game, which we've talked about pretty much since day one, had the best season in Georgia State football history running the football. Just over 2,000 yards, 2,057, 21 rushing touchdowns.
Yes.
Not taking anything away from any of the running backs, but Dan obviously was a big part of that.
Well, Dan was. Yeah. I think he rushed for over 600 yards. And to tell you the truth, we probably didn't run him like we could have earlier in the season. And he really came on there late. But he did a really nice job in the running aspect of our scheme. And those running backs for us, some of these true freshmen, Trey Barnett, all really stepped in there and did a nice job. I think they all were over 4-plus yards a carry, every single one of those backs. And anytime you increase your rushing attack from where we were and from where this program had been running the football, 60-plus yards, that's a significant amount. I mean, it just doesn't happen. You see people at times go maybe 10 to 20, but 60-plus yards is really something that we were proud of. And we got to continue to do that. I mean, we would like to be right at over 200-plus yards rushing a game.
Well, at the end of the season, you had to say goodbye to Penny Hart. He made the decision to graduate and go ahead and move on, but you still got a lot of young, up-and-coming receivers on this football team.
We do. I mean, Cornelius McCoy was our second leading receiver. I think he had, I can't remember the number, between 35 and 40 catches, just right behind Penny. True freshman, walked in here, and then you've got Tamir Jones that's going to be back, and we have some nice Sam Pinckney, another freshman that actually got injured, was really coming on, got into a starting role, and had an injury down at Troy on a fumble play. That will be back. So our receiving core, we're looking forward to having them guys come in, continue to grow, and then we're looking to add some playmakers in this next class.
Coach, we all know what facilities mean in the world of college athletics and college football. There's a lot of construction going on down here at Georgia State Stadium. Team has still been practicing over at 188, but by the time we get around to next season, You got a great locker room here where we are right now, and you're going to have a lot of great build-out around this locker room for football to move into before next season.
Yeah, it's funny. We're sitting here doing this interview right here, and I hear the construction going on back here. It's going to be a game-changer for us, just like the facilities that we have here now with this locker room, with the new weight room, the football operations, team meeting room, all of our like I said, our operations moving here to the stadium. And if you've seen this locker room, it's first class. And I can only imagine what the operations, the team meeting space, the weight room, everything involved that's going to make this a really, really special place. I'm telling you, it's amazing to see how this turned out, this locker room right here, and then to see how these facilities are going to pan out as well. It's an exciting time here at Georgia State football, and you know, a lot of people are going to come in here and their eyes are really going to be blown out because it's going to be a special looking place.
So looking ahead, 10 starters or 10 guys that started on offense returning, 9 on defense returning, and again, very busy. I know everybody in that coaching staff's all around out in the recruiting trail.
Yeah, you know, it's good to see that we have experience coming back, the 10 guys on offense, the 9 on defense. Now, we all understand we've got to coach these guys, and they've got to be better prepared, and they've got to be better fundamentally, and we've got to do the things necessary to have those returning guys really come in to make a huge difference for us. And then also, this recruiting trail is really special for us because we're out there and we're in homes. I mean, I'm telling you, we're in homes and the Georgia State name's out there. And these guys, these student athletes that we're bringing in here are really explosive, skilled athletes. The line that we're putting together, the offensive and defensive lines are really very, very critical. So our staff's doing a good job getting out and getting these guys on campus.
All right, Coach, appreciate it. Best of luck. Bring some good recruits back here. Looking forward to the season already.
We are. I mean, you know, our staff does a great job, and our student athletes here and this university in itself does a great job in this recruiting, but we're planning on bringing some great ones in.
All right, I'm Dave Cohen. That's Georgia State's head football coach, Shawn Elliott.